welcome to Turkey. So we are in the ancient part of Istanbul. Yeah. Somehow we are close to the Taksim Square, and when we done with this road you will see a beautiful road and lots of ancient buildings and places. Cool. Hope you will like it.
Thank you. Of course.
How was your trip, by the way?
That was what?
How was your trip?
Oh, how was my trip? Oh, to be honest, it was great. We got into London at 1, I think. Mm-hmm. And then we just waited for a bit and then had a flight, safe flight, everything fine. And then Sumit picked us up from the airport as well, so that was really nice. Didn't have to worry about transport.
So yeah.
Yeah, that was really good.
So it's your first 20 hours in Istanbul.
Yeah,
it's your first time here, right?
Yes.
Then welcome. Julia, we are in front of Galata Tower,
yeah.
And there is a myth saying that if you are going up with somebody, you will get married.
Aww, that's so cute. Harry, yeah. You better take me.
So this is a romantic place.
Aww.
Somehow. Maybe one day you will be proposed here. Julia, welcome to Turkey once again. It's been how many hours since you are here?
Nearly a day now, but you took us on the tour of the ancient city Taksim. 2 hours?
Yeah, we've been into Taksim and we walk a lot, so we are
hungry
and a little tired, so we are in such a beautiful restaurant, I guess. So you're here for your nose surgery.
Yeah, rhinoplasty. I'm so, honestly, it's been my dream since I was 11, and it's just so overwhelming that it's finally happening after so many years, especially here. Like, I've always wanted to go to Turkey, and like, what better way to come to Turkey than coming here, spending a few days in an ancient city, and then having a rhinoplasty of your dreams. Like, so excited.
Yeah, okay, so it's gonna be your first surgery.
Yeah, I've never had any surgery, no.
So it's supposed to be more exciting.
Yeah, it's like, it's gonna be definitely an experience. I've never been under anesthesia or anything, never. Had anything.
You'll be fine.
Like, yeah.
I'm pretty sure you're so energetic.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Nice. And if you have a real nice soul.
Yeah.
So it will impact your
some
whole
good
processes.
Karma.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah.
The karma. Good karma will find you, I guess.
Yeah.
So it's your first time in Turkey.
Yeah.
Is it first time abroad?
No, not abroad. I've been abroad to loads of places, but I've never been to Turkey.
Because like when you say like I'm going to Turkey, people may like feel little, how to say it?
Cautious.
Because it's a Muslim country.
Yeah.
People are thinking different about
Turkey. We've been here for a day now nearly. Nothing out of the ordinary. It's literally just the same as if you'd go to England. Like, I don't see any difference. So I feel it's just kind of more of a stereotype of the whole country being like so conservative, but I feel like it just depends where you go. But
definitely, yeah.
I haven't experienced anything negative, so
conservative places.
Yeah,
like we are a mixture of everything here in the Middle East. But I'm wondering, like, when you tell it to your parents, to your friends, I'm going to Turkey for rhinoplasty. What? How did they?
Yeah, they definitely were worried. They were like, there's been some deaths, and I'm like, every surgery has some complications. It's not just Turkey. Every single place has you know, deaths and all that stuff, but I've seen your clinic and there's no deaths, there's no
search for it, right?
So I've searched doctors. Like, I've researched it, and I was like, this is a really good rhinoplasty doctor, so I might as well go to Turkey and get it, because I want to get it done professionally so well that like I'll just love it instantly. And like, I'm not sure if I'd be able to achieve that if I wasn't in Turkey, for example, with vanity. So
You said that you have been searching while you were 11.
Yeah.
It's so hard. So I believe that you searched other countries other than Turkey.
I was mainly looking.
How did you find it?
I was mainly looking at Poland because I'm from Poland. Yeah. So one, the price is going to be cheaper, definitely. But Turkey overall, I feel like the ethnic noses in Turkey are similar to what I have mostly. So I just feel like they'd be able to handle it easier than someone, than someone from like America or like England, where the nose shape and like the whole face is completely different to what I have, considering I'm Eastern European. So
yeah, when I look at your nose in our north part of Turkey, there are lots of people have
with a similar nose.
I used to have one.
Yeah,
and take the Turkish doctor.
Yeah,
I got a rhino.
Yeah.
As well. So after we have something here, we are going near to our doctors.
Yeah,
and you will meet with him for the first time.
Yeah,
and he will take you see your nose. And you will plan your surgery.
I'm so excited.
So next hour you will be in the doctor room.
Yeah.
So say goodbye for now.
Bye-bye.
And we will see you in the hospital.
All right. Bye.